Okay, I said I'd give you an update, but nitrous bottle's mounted, trying to keep the weight back here. The water tank's mounted. That's what I'm going to use for the cooler. It's a 12 by 12, 30 row. 10 AN in and out. It's got a little electric fan on it. So they don't give you any brackets, so I zip tied it on there for now until I can find something. And yeah, I did put something between the fan and the cooler. It's got some little rubber glue on, like strip stuff around it to protect it. But that's where it's going to end up going for now. The battery is going to end up getting moved. Up here, not really in a hurry to do anything. I did get rid of the 1-inch spacer. All that's going to be underneath here is going to be the nitrous plate and the solenoid bracket. Got rid of the plate. Drilled and tapped, put a fitting right there for the blow-off valves. And then I've got a manifold that'll feed off the back of this hat right here that'll be back here to feed everything needing boost. The gauge, the fuel pressure regulator, and all that. I got this fitting all done. It's welded up. That's about what it'll look like. We changed this. I'm not using this one. I got one that's a little straighter from the same place, silicone intake systems. For this one, CX Racing, it comes in an angle. The other one comes and actually turns a full 90 degrees. So I don't have to use these 30 degree elbows. I can actually just use a straight coupler. So, and then just use a 3.5 to 3 up here. I'm gonna use the Holley hat. I'm gonna put this underneath it. It's got O-rings on both sides to give it direct the air straighter into the carburetor. If it don't work, I'll go with the, I got three hats. I got this one, I got the Extreme Velocity hat, and then I got that damn Spectre hat. So, carburetor's got the power valves in it now. I've got to weld this up so I can get the exhaust on it. I shortened up, shortened the oil line, return lines up so they are more direct going down to the pan on both sides. So it's a straight drop. They're not curved out and then back in. I took about 3.5-4 inches out of each one. Right now I'm waiting on fuel. Either VP MS-109 or Sunoco 260 GT Plus. They're about the same fuel basically. Highly oxygenated, high octane unleaded ratio. Well, I finally found a place in St. Joe. The VP station got bought out and they're trying to get their stock and everything put back together and what people want, what people need. And all they got C16 and methanol. So I went over there and placed the order for 4 5-gallon jugs. And then Wednesday or Thursday, if I get time beforehand, we're gonna run up to St. Joe and get some Sunoco. There's also a guy that sells Sunoco here locally. And he's going to start getting it in for me. So all I got to do is drive about 6-7 minutes from the house and get it. Because the 260 GT Plus is the same as MS-109. So. Other than that, it's ready to go. It's just throw shit on it and fire it up. And then start playing around with it. I got the springs changed in the wastegates. Like I said, if the VS Racing gates give me trouble, I got some precision gates I'll put on it and use them. But we dropped the spring rate from basically a 5-pound spring down to a 3-pound spring. We're using an MVS spring for a 38mm MVS gate. When you put those in an MVR 45mm gate, it drops them down to like 2.9 pounds a piece. So like I said, we're going to start out at 6 pounds. Kind of dial stuff in and play with it a little bit. That way it's not making enough boost to hurt anything, which I don't think it hurt it at 10 pounds. I know it wouldn't. But start off small and we'll work our way in. If everything goes right, I'll change them out. And what I can do is just keep the low pound springs in that VS racing gates, and then I can up it to, you know, 12, 16 pounds somewhere on the precision gates. All I gotta do is unclamp it, clamp it, hook a hose up, and I'm back to going. Play with stuff a little bit and we're good to go. This is all learning curve. So that way I can get that back on my wife's El Camino. She ain't driving it, but I got another carburetor on there just to cover everything up, and I need to get it switched back. But that's about all we've got done. Everything else is plumbed in. All the lines pretty much are run. All the fuel lines run into the regulator, out of the regulator, gauge is hooked in. Got the other gauge up here to measure fuel pressure at the carburetor. One's to measure at the pump. This one's for the carburetor so I can see it and watch everything while I'm in the truck. So I just got to tighten it up there, but I ain't going to do it till I get it where I want it. It may end up going on the other side. I'd like for them, when I put the hood on it, that 6-inch cowl scoop, all of this will be underneath it. So, and I'll probably have to cut the hood for all of this, but I don't care. So, and that little ice tank back there, or water tank, you can call it, and that little cooler, and then I got a Mazir pump that's mounted under the truck, is what's going to feed these in, out, back through the cooler, back to the tank, circulate it back up here. So, and when I really want to get after it hard, the nitrous is going to act to help cool the motor as well. So that's it. Ain't got nothing else to report other than that battery is going to go back over there in that corner. I got a weight box to go back here if I ever decide to race. But I can't say I won't race it. I can't say I will race it. So it's just a toy for me. It's just a damn toy, a hot rod. So, but I may take it out and race it. If I get a chance, take it out on the street, take it out the track, whatever. And see what happens. I'm going to make me a bracket for here because I'm going to put the nitrous on the button. I don't want it on the carburetor. I'm going to make me a button bracket with a button. That's the way I'm used to doing it, with a button right here. So basically when I got a hold of this, like this, my button will be right here behind the shifter. And then I'll put the purge button back here somewhere, up there someplace, for the purge solenoid. I ain't putting the steering wheel. The only thing I want up here is line lock and trans brake. That's it. So, not too much done. Again, waiting on fuel. I've run it enough to get the timing set. I'd like to go back and double check everything. The new cap and rotors on it. Change the eccentric so I can get the timing spread where I want it. But double check it. And use my ghetto IV bottle that's hanging there, but it works. And run it, double check everything, swap carburetors, hook all the charge pipes up, get all that shit done, exhaust on it, and then go from there. So, but I'm hoping this will help direct the air more straight down, and then I got to put vent extensions up into there yet, but I'll do that off of the other carburetor. So, and it's sitting right there, all the nitrous lines, all the shit for the nitrous, purge, plate, more parts, crap. Got all my trash bagged up. Got this all pulled apart. Hang the fenders, get the hood on it, off the donor car, get everything squirted, the bumper cover. Put the new core support up there, get everything squared up, weld it in, put it back together, and give it back to the kid. And if he wrecks it again, I ain't fixing it. Yeah. There's the old rad support. and the hood hinges where it shoved them back. Well, it shoved one of them back till it hit the lock so the hood couldn't pop up. But said I got a whole donor car, so I ain't worried about it. Ain't in a hurry anyway. He's got something to drive. It's just that's a lot easier on gas than what he's got. So, but that's all we got done, guys, gals. And I see I hit 1,000 subs. Thank you to everyone. That just blows me away. Absolutely blows me away that I hit the 1,000 mark. I never thought I'd get 100, let alone 1,000. It just, that's just too cool. Thank you to everybody that subbed to me. Just keep watching, because once I get fuel, stuff is going to start going real quick. I'm going to set the camera up, full battery, and just let it run while we're out here working. I ain't even going to pay attention to the camera, so you'll get to see everything as it happens. So, everybody, stay safe, God bless, and keep making videos. And I'll put more up when I get some fuel, which will probably be Wednesday or Thursday. Later.